Hello, my people. Now we the Nation Voice. The voice when they review the secret things when it be said the government, the politician that is say they cover. In case you just join us for the first time, I bet and the first time when they watch us for this channel be this, I say you are welcome. I bet do me a favor. You see that red subscribe button? Press them. And the small bell when they near them, press them as well. So that anytime when we upload new video again, you go be the first person to watch. And I pray the same way when the people say they support us for this channel. Now the same way when God with the same people when will they support you for everything when they do for life. In Jesus' name. Amen. And with that, we don't waste any of your time again. May we go straight to the news we will get today. All right, my people, may we touch on small small. From among the plenty news when the business we get for our table today. To start with, Zamfara State Governor don't talk say for the 2020 budget, he don't put 1 billion naira aside to renovate mosque and cemetery. It work. And this one are the news when the business he reach our table for January 1st, 2020. The Zamfara State Government don't talk, they say they don't mark out 1 billion naira to construct Jumok at Mosque, Ramadan packages, and as well to construct cemetery this 2020. And this one at the world when it be said the State Commissioner of Religious Affairs, when it be said in name, na Sh0ck1ng, when it be say he disclosed the time when he did defend the 2020 budget at the Ministry of the House of Assembly for Jusau on Tuesday. And he still can further explain, say for the 1 billion naira, for inside they will use 300 million naira to buy special gift for Ramadan when it be say it will happen for 2020. Because the government don't already get a place when it be said that the co-feeding center, when it be said during the Ramadan fast, people they gather. And it still come for that explain again. Say for the 2020 budget, say they plan to build additional Jumo at mosque for 17 states and as well to establish one Islamic education center for the 3 senatorial districts. And for inside the news, he can see for that talk, say they don't take notice, say for all the cemetery, when it be say it is inside the state, all of them don't break down. Say they will try to make sure say they renovate all the cemetery, when it be say it is inside the state. And if possible, they will also build new ones. All right, my people, now the news when it be say we receive from Zamfara State Government, now it be this one. Concerning the 2020 budget, when it be said they don't already get for grant. Before I will leave, una make una share una opinion with me for the comment section as we always do. I just want to talk small concerning this very budget for Zamfara State Government. A lot of people, they make budget ahead of 2020. And now, only something when it be said with the here now. Now, the budget when it be said it concern mosque. And as well, consign cemetery. The one of mosque, me are not really too much bother. That one are a place for prayer. But what about the one when it be say cemetery? Oh, this man now or this government now that they plan for their citizen to die. Now what it be their budget? Now it be this one. Everyone they make budget. Waiting will make their citizen to live well. Good road, good hospital. Marketplaces be repaired. They not see all this one. They go, they make budget for cemetery. Make they renovate cemetery. If possible, say they want build new cemetery. If now, majority of three of us will be saying, no, understand what it be cemetery. Burial ground. Where they bury people when they die. Now this one be the budget when it be say a whole state. They make plan for. As for me, this one has something when it be say it tire me. I don't know how I want to explain it. That is why I say make I still can share with you now. Make una still share una opinion with me for the comment section. If this one na good thing when it be say a whole state supposed to come out for public co announce for as budget for 2020. I don't know how I want to explain it. Make una share una opinion with me. As we move down to another news. And moving on again, the wind of 2023 election don't they blow. and area boys don't deform innocenty. Watch this video. I will come back.
So why are we surprised? All the good people keep away from politics. Who will be in politics? It's a vacuum. It will be filled by bad people. If all the good people go abroad or join the private sector, who is going to be in government? The people that are not so good. And this is what is happening. We are seeing an intersection of bad people in government, bad people in politics, and our country is running down. It's going down the drain.
Now even the good ones that want to get involved, that is that kind of a tactical way of edging them out of the contest.
Because they are not a critical mass. There are very few of them. There are very few of them. When we were in the government, only about four of us as ministers could stand up and say we disagreed with President Obasanjo. There are 42 ministers. Only about four that I remember could speak in council against anything Obasanjo wanted to do if we disagreed. Why?
So others will just agree with
you. Everybody will keep quiet. And this is the problem. When you pick people that have never achieved anything in their lives and put them in these very senior government positions, they want to remain there forever. They will do anything to remain there. They would not tell the president the truth. They would not look at the governor and tell him the truth, which is their job as advisors. Because a minister is an advisor to the president.
In that case, is it the fault of the people or the fault of the man who plays them? Because
no, it is a bit of both, okay? It is the fault of the elites, in my opinion. I won't say the people. In every society, the elites, those that are privileged with education, money, or influence, are the ones that ought to sit down and set the tone for the structure of that society. Okay? If our elites have chosen not to go into politics and set that tone, as I said, there is a vacuum, the bad ones will take over. We've seen that in Nigeria. So there is that. It is also true that the leader that picks those around him is culpable, because you are responsible for those you select. Okay? You are constrained to some extent, because our constitution, for instance, says that the president must appoint a minister from each state. But it doesn't say that you should appoint a criminal from the state. It says that you should look for the best possible person and appoint him to be minister. So there are constraints, but still, I believe that in this country we have so much talent that if we are really looking for square pegs to put in square holes, we will find them. And there is a...
I think it has to do with the sincerity of the person in charge.
As I said, leaders must be checked. Absolute power, power corrupts. Absolute power corrupts absolutely. So leaders must be checked. It is in their own interest to create a system that they are checked. Okay, if they are not checked, even good people become bad people. I have seen that transformation. I know many people that I have worked with, that I have interacted with, that were really good when we worked together. Some of them have become governors and ministers, and they have become monsters. Because there is no check and balance. Leaders must be checked throughout history. So it is not just the leader. The people must be able to speak out. The people must complain. The elites must come and say, this is not acceptable. But in this country, we have a conspiracy of silence by the elites. Everybody just keeps quiet because everybody is just waiting for his turn. And it is not taking us anywhere. We are all going to be consumed by this crisis. This keg of gunpowder that we're sitting on, in which 75% of the population is below the age of 35, they have no jobs, no hope, and they have not seen a country that ever functioned.
My people, I only laugh. I believe say a lot of una know who be this man when he be say they talk so. This one na Nancy El-Rufai, the governor of Kaduna State. I know say a lot of una know him, but I just want to make a introduce him to una again. And again, nasty this man, when he be say he use knee lead down to make sure say he bring Governor Yahaya Bello, the one of Kogi State, to power again. Although for the first year when he be say this man rule, he know say he not do well, but he decide to make sure say he lead down. After he don't lead down finish, he make sure say he support he lead down, make he not come become a disgrace to run. He support him with knife and gun to make sure say he achieve his dream. Now it be this one when he sit down, so this they give fine, beautiful speech concerning leadership, how you will fit to make things work for Nigeria. All this one they come just because they get eye for 2023 presidential election. So nobody be fools. We, our eyes not they close. Because I continue to use this word, say, for the fact say we not feel really do the thing the way it's supposed to be. Not me say we not get sense. I be these people, make I ask this question. Oh, why be say they, when it be say they in power right from the beginning of 1960, why they be believe to say now only they would they come back to that office? Say without them, this office not fit function. Why if they not be the selfish people? Thank God he still make mention of leader being selfish. If they are not selfish and self-centered, why be say they not they give chance to the new coming children, the new coming youth? May they still exercise their waiting they get, they don't acquire. Whether these people like them or not, we are in a computer age. Their time, their idea don't expire. May they give chance to the young generation. May they exhibit waiting they don't acquire for this life. The knowledge, when we say the new generation, this computer age, this 21st century gets, not be the knowledge when these people get. It not feel they possible. No matter how they think say that they wide, no matter how they think say they don't already know the system of this power, government, or whatsoever the case may be. It not feel work. It not feel work. These people. I don't know what I want to talk concerning them. May not come be say if I really say make a voice the way when it day my mind. It will be like say me a day as in I maybe a day, I get bad belly for them, but their way not declare. They know me well for our nation. They know me well for Nigerians. They know me well for the future of our children. Now only waiting I want to be this one. I know say my opinion not to be the best one for everybody, but I just speak my own mind. May I still live on? May una still voice on our mind for us for the comment session. So with this now, I want to like to bring this video to an end because I know say I don't really take much of una time. And I want you this moment to appreciate each and every one of una for una time, una support, una be like say una don't support us so far for this channel. God will continue to bless una. And one thing when I want to beg una again, una still continue to support us so that we will continue to speak out. We'll continue to let these people they know say, not be say we not really know what thing that they do. But we believe on God and we believe on this struggle that one day, God will uplift our hand to really achieve our dream and our purpose. So I beg, Mona C, help us share this video, like and comment until we see you again when we see you. Bye-bye.